Alright, what's going on, guys? Boy TG, welcome back to another video. So in this video, we're going to be talking about and breaking down the best plays of Patrick Kane and Alex Debrincat when they were on the Chicago Blackhawks. Now, if you guys don't know already, Patrick Kane is already a member of the Detroit Red Wings. He signed with them already. I think this was released like about a week ago. I'm not really sure if I'm being honest with you guys, but that's not the point. He's on the Red Wings now. He is reunited with Alex Debrincat. They played like, what, 5 seasons together on the Blackhawks, and they're back at it in Detroit. So if you guys missed the video where I talked about which teams could we see Patrick Kane go to, you will know that I said the Red Wings, that's one of the options, and I was right. And that's kind of what most people had predicted. So this will be his 17th season in the NHL. Of course, he had the surgery back in June, so it's nice to see him making a return to the NHL. Last year, he got 57 points in 73 games, 45 with the Chicago Blackhawks, and 12 with the New York Rangers. So, and in those 5 seasons, I believe in this 5 seasons that Kane and Debrincat played with the Blackhawks, because I know Debrincat went to Ottawa and Kane was still on the Blackhawks. But they managed to get a total of 735 points together with the Blackhawks. So during those 5 seasons right there, Alex Debrincat with 307 and Patrick Kane with 428 points with the Blackhawks. Before Debrincat got traded to the Senators. Which, if you ask me, it was a stupid trade by the Blackhawks. I think they still should have kept Alex Debrincat. But anyway, in Patrick Kane's career, he's had 1,237 points in 1,180 games. So that's nice to see from Patrick Kane. And he will, I'm guessing, when he plays in the Red Wings lineup when he makes his debut, whatever. He'll be playing with Alex Debrincat and Dylan Larkin. That's just my prediction. I'm guessing that's what some of you guys predicted as well. He'll be playing with Alex Debrincat and Dylan Larkin on the same line. But anyway, let's get into it. I'm not going to waste any more time talking about that as much as I want to. I'm going to get right into these top 10 plays right here from Patrick Kane and Alex Debrincat. So we're going to go ahead and start now. So this was against Colorado. And you guys see Patrick Kane. I know it's a little bit blurry, but he made a spin around pass right there to Alex Debrincat. And he makes it 1-0 Blackhawks. So that was a great play from Kaner. So we'll see it again. So great, great play, like I said. I think this is a better view. So that's Kane right there. Like I said, I understand that it's bloggy, but just bear with me. So that's Kane right there, and he's going to make a spin-around play, and he's known to do that. I've seen him do that a few times in his career already, and he does it right here against the Colorado Avalanche. So great play from Kane. Kane makes a lot of great plays in his career. If you guys don't know, the other dynamic duo on the Blackhawks, Patrick Kane, Jonathan Toews. And I know those two had came up big together for points right there. You guys see Dylan Strome also celebrating with Alex Debrincat. They did play together on the same team during the, I think it was either WHL or OHL that Alex Debrincat and Dylan Strome played together. But anyway, you guys just saw another great play from Patrick Kane. Deacon through the Coyotes D, and I know the Coyotes goalie's upset. And Alex Debrincat pops a goal. So this duo is going to be exciting to watch for the Detroit Red Wings. So I can't wait when Patrick Kane makes his debut with the Red Wings. I don't know when that will be, but I plan to have this video out on the day that he makes his debut. So I think it might be against Ottawa, or who knows. But anyway, nice play from Kane going through the Coyotes D, and then dropping a pass off to Alex Debrincat, who one times it in from the slot of the left circle for a goal right there, and he just celebrates with Patrick Kane. Man, I miss this duo so much on the Blackhawks. As you guys don't know already, I said this a few times on this channel. I am a Chicago Blackhawks fan, and I know we suck, but we got Connor Bedard, and I'm hoping in the next few years or so that the Blackhawks can win the Stanley Cup. And I'm hoping that this rebuild is worth it, because I know on and off the ice they have had so many issues. For one thing, the Blackhawks terminated Corey Perry's contract. So Corey Perry is no longer on the team, unfortunately. And that's sad, because I think he could have been a great role model for Connor Bedard, even though he wasn't number one overall pick, but he is a Stanley Cup champion and was a great player to watch in his prime. And I think he could have just been that another role model for Connor Bedard. But as you guys see right here, this was in the bubble right here. And so Alex Debrincat, he's going to come behind the net. He's going to drop off a play for Patrick Kane right there. And he pops it in. This was during the qualifying round in the bubble, by the way, before the Blackhawks went on to face the Vegas Golden Knights, who lost to them in the first round, unfortunately. But yeah, like I was saying about the Corey Perry termination contract, I think he could have been a great role model for Connor Bedard. I think I've seen one video before where it was just Corey Perry and Connor Bedard out on the ice, and Perry was dropping off Bedard some pucks, and Bedard was one time them into the net. Now it's just great to see. Taylor Hall could have been another one, because I think Taylor Hall was also drafted in the first round, so another first round pick right there. And I think even though Patrick Kane's not on the team no more, I think Taylor Hall could have been another great role model for Connor Bedard, but he's going to be out for the remainder of the season. And there's no telling who Andres after the season is going to come back. So I don't know what to say right there for the Blackhawks. But as you guys see right here, Blackhawks go up the ice. And Patrick Kane, guess who he's looking at? He's looking at Alex Debrincat. Alex Debrincat is looking at him right back. So they see each other coming up the ice, and he's just going to lay a pass down for Alex Debrincat, and he goes backhand on Vika Vanacek. So great goal right there. What a play from Kaner. All right. And this was also in the bubble. As you guys see, there are no fans right there. This was the Blackhawks and Stars. So in the bubble, it was kind of different. Not going to lie. I'm pretty sure all you guys know this. It was a little bit different. I did hate it that there was no fans there. And you couldn't even go to the games. Like, I wanted to go to a few Blackhawks games during this time. But COVID ruined everything. It ruined everything. That's why during the 2020 time, everybody was staying at home. Everybody was going out with masks and stuff. So it ruined everything that year. But yeah, it is what it is. But nice passing play for Patrick Kane. There's Miro Heiskanen there trying to get the puck away from Kaner. But Kaner says, not a chance. And he just spots Alex Debrincat right there, out in front of the net, puts it past. I think that's Hudobin. Is that Hudobin? I don't even know. But puts it past the Stars goalie for the overtime winner. And there's Malcolm Subban right there when he was on the Blackhawks. I don't know if he's not playing in the NHL right now. So he may have retired. I don't know. Or he's in the AHL. I really don't know. But as you guys see right there, as you guys just saw, great pass from Kane and Debrincat. Wide open left circle with a wide open net. And he puts it past Casey the Smith right there. So Alex Debrincat wide open in that left circle slot. Show it to you guys from this angle. So he's got all the net right there. And that's just enough to get the puck past Casey the Smith right there. So great play from Kane. Great goal for Alex Debrincat. Like I said, I cannot wait to see them play together in Detroit. Now, with the Yiser plan going on, I mean, Steve Yzerman, a former NHL player, former team captain for the Detroit Red Wings, former Stanley Cup champion with the Red Wings. I think he won three. I don't know if he – I know the Red Wings won in 2008. I think that was their last Stanley Cup. I think Yzerman won three because it was in 97. And in 98, the Red Wings won back-to-back cups that year, 97-98. And then I think he won one in 2002 because Detroit won against Carolina that year in 2002. But was he with them in that 2018? I don't know. I'm going to be honest with you. I don't know if Steve Yzerman was with the Red Wings during the 2008 Stanley Cup run. But I know he was with them in that back-to-back years, 97-98, because they won back-to-back. And then 2002. I don't know about 2008. It wasn't in 2008. Because I think Yzerman retired. I think Yzerman retired and Nick Lidstrom was named the captain. So, yeah. Yzerman retired that year and Nick Lidstrom was named the captain. And speaking of Carolina, you guys just saw Alex Debrincat pop that goal right there. I know I was mentioning Carolina when I was talking about the 2002 Stanley Cup final right there. So, anyway, going on to the next one. These are 10 clips in this playlist, guys. So, 10 clips. I don't know what clip we're on right now, to be honest. It's got to be like the fifth or sixth one. But this is another goal against the Hurricanes. This time it was in the bubble right there. Alex Debrincat gets the goal. So, like I said, I think everybody's excited to see Kane play with Alex Debrincat on the Red Wings. Now, I know I'm a Blackhawks fan, and I know the rivalry between the Blackhawks and the Red Wings. And I hate to see both those players. I kind of like it, and I kind of hate it. I like it because Kane is reunited with Alex Debrincat. He's coming back for his 17th NHL season. And I don't like it because they're on the Red Wings, which is kind of a rival team to the Chicago Blackhawks. So I'm kind of in between this one, guys. So, but the Red Wings should at least go to the first round of the playoffs, if not the second round, but at least the first round. They probably won't have a deep playoff run if they somehow happen to make the playoffs this year with Kane and Debrincat and all the other people on the Red Wings. But they should at least go to the first round, at least be in the first round, if not farther enough from that. But great play from Patrick Kane, setting up Alex Debrincat in front of the net. No chance for Alex Nedeljkovic right there, who had a goalie goal in the AHL for the Pittsburgh Penguins AHL team. So that was nice to see right there. Going to the next clip. So this was also in the bubble right here. I mean, not in the bubble. Jeez. This was also in during the 2020-2021 season when there was, like, no fans in the arena, nothing like that going on. So, yeah. Let me see what clip we're on. So I'm going to exit out of here for a second, guys, if it can load. Okay, we're on the second to last clip. We're on clip 9. Clip 9 right there. So we're almost through this, guys. I could have found more if I wanted to, but usually I do like 5. If I'm breaking down something, which I know throughout this video, I kind of have been doing it and I kind of have been doing it. But usually if I'm like breaking down something, I usually add like at least 5 to 10 clips. No more than 10, but it's usually like 5 to 10. Right there, but great play from Patrick Kane. Debrincat is wide open right there, coming in front of net. You got two defenders right there on Kaner. So nobody's covering Alex Debrincat, and he just takes it to the net and puts it past Jonas Korpisalo, who's currently on the Senators, so no longer on the Blue Jackets. Now it's great heads-up play from Patrick Kane. That's something I would recommend to you young players starting to play hockey. Like, if you got, like, two defenders, or if you got somebody that you see wide open right there, like Kane saw Alex Debrincat wide open. I should mention, too, that the puck went between this guy's legs, and it went to Alex Debrincat. So that was actually kind of cool, too. So scoring that goal right there. And let's get forward to our last clip. And like I said, I will have this video come out when Patrick Kane makes his debut. That will be the day that this video will come out. I don't really know when he's going to make his debut with the Red Wings, but there's not like a certain date. No, no, no. I'll try to have this video come out before the debut, but I don't know. We'll just have to see, guys. That's all I can say. All right, so great play from Patrick Kane from behind the net, spotting out Alex Debrincat, putting the puck past Jacob Markstrom right there. And that's also great read as well. Great read from Kaner. It's always nice to step up your teammate from behind the net. And I think that was a power play goal. Let me go back. Was that a power? Okay, that wasn't a power play goal. Okay. Usually plays like that will be on the power play. So, yeah. It's kind of why I thought maybe that would have been a power play goal, but it wasn't. So, yeah. But anyway, guys, let me pause this. That is going to do it for this video. So, let me know how excited are you guys to see this duo at it again in Detroit. Patrick Kane, Alex Debrincat. Now, I know for all you Blackhawks fans out there like myself, you hate to see – you kind of hate to see it happen because, like I say, he's going to the Red Wings. So it feels like a betrayal since the Blackhawks and Red Wings are rivals with each other. It kind of feels like a betrayal, but it's also kind of happy too because going to be playing with Alex Debrincat, Dylan Larkin, Moisai, Lucas Raymond, all the other talent on that Red Wings roster right there. So I'm actually kind of happy that this happened. I'm actually kind of not. So like I said, it's in between. But yeah, let me know what you guys think down in the comments. Are you ready for this duo to go at, I mean, are you ready for this duo to put up points for this team? Are you ready to see Patrick Kane in his 17th NHL season? Playing with Alex Debrincat and the Red Wings. And let me know, how far do you think the Red Wings will go in the playoffs? If they do make the playoffs. If they do make the playoffs. And if they're a Stanley Cup contender, I don't think they're a Stanley Cup. Actually, they're doing really good. They're doing really good. So if they go into a playoff run, how far do you guys think the Red Wings will make the playoffs? I say they're at least going to make it to the first round. Some people might say otherwise, but I want to see you guys' comments down below. So let me know down below how deep of a playoff run do you see the Red Wings going to if they somehow happen to make the playoffs. Anyway, guys, that is going to do it for this video. Make sure you're following up on the TG Hockey Blog. That's www.tgnhlhockeyblog.weebly.com. Again, that's www.tgnhlhockeyblog.weebly.com. Now, I'm going to say this one thing about it. I don't post every NHL game that comes on because, like I said, nobody wants to do that. I don't want to do that. So that's why I only post the articles that I'm kind of interested in posting. You don't see all these NHL people who write the articles. It's not just one person that does it. It's a few other people. But because this is my blog, I get to choose the articles and news that I want to write about on the TG Hockey Blog. So make sure you're following up on that. I will put the URL link in the description so you guys can get to it faster. And also, don't forget to like and subscribe to this channel. We are on the road to 400 subscribers. I know I haven't been on here a lot, but I'm looking forward to putting out more videos on the TG Hockey channel. So make sure you subscribe to that. Like I said, on the road to 400 subscribers. And yeah, I'll see you guys next time.